Good afternoon. It's great to be here with all of you. I too want to join the speaker and the governor in recognizing the partnership that we have shared on working on the many challenges that Rhode Island faces. And this is perhaps one of the greatest that face us. I also want to recognize Majority Leader Don McNerio, who's here with me today. The collaboration on this particular issue stretches to our cities and towns, the state level, the federal government is represented here, as well as the public sector and the private sector. It is an example of true collaboration and what that can bring us. It's no secret that the roads and bridges in our state are among the worst in the nation. The U.S. Department of Transportation has reported that while many of our economic indicators are improving, that in fact, Rhode Island ranks 50th. And yet, Rhode Island motorists don't need a survey to tell them what they can see, what they can feel for themselves as they drive around the state. Our roads and bridges are in deplorable condition. And that's just the potholes that we see and that we feel. That doesn't speak to the integrity of our overpasses and bridges, which to the naked eye looks sound. The roadworks proposal that the governor presents today places the burden of bridge maintenance squarely and fairly on the large commercial trucks that are causing more than 90% of the wear and tear on our roads and bridges. This proposal is something that Rhode Island needs right now. It's imperative that we invest in our roads and bridges. And as the governor has stated, failure to do so will result in much higher costs in the future. This approach utilizes an approach that's taken in every other Northeast state, and it's an approach with which commercial truckers are very familiar. The economic benefits that come from living in a state with a fair, predictable road maintenance system, a system that attracts entrepreneurs in part because it has quality road and bridge infrastructure, and a way to pay for it, may be hard to measure. But what's not hard to measure, one thing that can be quantified, as the governor Schumer said, are the construction jobs. We all have acknowledged that the construction industry was one of the hardest hit during the recession, and it has been slow to recover. Even as the unemployment rate has improved in Rhode Island, has gained jobs over the past few months, the construction industry continues to struggle, losing 1,200 jobs over the last 3 months. This roadworks proposal is estimated to put thousands of construction workers back on the job, and that's good for the economy. Yes! As the speaker said, the Senate and the House Finance Committees will thoroughly examine all the nuances of the roadworks program. We will be sensitive and have spoken to Director Alpidi about ensuring that we address the concerns of our Rhode Island businesses and our Rhode Island truckers. But the proposal will be embedded in a public and transparent process that really considers our Rhode Island businesses. But it's clear, despite that fact that some will express naysayers will want to speak up first and foremost, it is clear, it's abundantly clear that we need to invest in our roads and bridges. This proposal appears to be a very good proposal that puts Rhode Islanders back to work, saves motorists and taxpayers money, and places the burden for upkeep barely upon the vehicles that cause their wear and tear through a system that's in place in many of the states. So on behalf of the Senate, grateful to leadership of Governor Raimondo and Director Alvini and the federal government in particular. And we look forward to reviewing the details of this proposal. Thanks, everybody.